Hey guys, this is Thinking Philosopher here, and today we are talking about reconstructing the modern Platonicism series. Where we left off, I don't know, that's been a long time ago. But where we're picking back up on is actually, in my opinion, most appropriate to tackle Boethius. He is not a well-known philosopher, he's actually even further unknown that he was actually a saint in the church, but Saint Boethius doesn't sound as good as Boethius. His full name, you can find it online, but he's often called Severinus Boethius. Yeah, let's go with that, Severinus. So, background knowledge about him is that he was born at the fall of the Roman Empire. Roughly, around the fall of the Western Roman Empire. The Ostrogoths could go and they kill every last bit of the Roman Empire. They then put their government based off the Roman infrastructure with the Senate and everything. Boethius comes in the picture. He's from an ancient Roman family. And he loves philosophy and all. And he becomes a very successful advisor to the king of the Ostrogoths. But, and that's a big but, he soon fell out of favor with the king when turned out that he was not of the beliefs of the Arian Christians, but more of a Orthodox Catholic type, Chalcedonian Nicene type of Christian. Now, this is a very interesting thing because Socrates too was killed for disagreeing with the state. That's kind of a common factor in philosophy, isn't it? So, I will talk about the constellations of philosophy on a later episode. Actually, I can divvy that out a little bit. Right now, I would like to talk more about the dialectics. Now, dialectics in Boethius' day was more based off the Socratic method. And so, instead of having two separate propositions, like if Socrates was a man, or Socrates was not a man. Oh my. So, you'd have more a question of having questions. So, it'd be more like, what is the way we should practice virtue? Or how did this person practice virtue in this context? And these questions, the thesis is called the question where it's more vague, so it would be like, how do you practice justice? And you do that to lead the conversation through the proposal, which would be the answer to that, whether it's X is the case or X is not the case. Then you go to the hypothesis, which is the more particulars, like was Cicero justly exiled for his crimes against the Roman citizens and having unjustly punished certain citizens? Or was Brutus right in killing Caesar? And these things we think of a lot of times when we have discussions, we think of questions as something that's actually, it's not, we think of it as a source of confusion. No, it's not really a source of confusion. It's not anything blind. We shouldn't be ashamed to ask questions. We should actually love to ask questions. Because what happens is you get a good thing going on. People learn from asking questions. Everyone learns. The dialectic bounces off each other. There's more humility to it. Because you're not just asserting your opinion of, well, I think Socrates was unjustly killed, or I think Socrates was a woman, or whatever. Although I don't know anyone who would think Socrates is a woman. Then you have many different types of questions, like either or type questions. You have, if this is the case, then what would you say this? Which some people would say is leading on, but there's really not, it's not really a bad thing to lead someone to a certain point in a conversation that actually helps direct the conversation where you, or the dialectic where you can actually get to a certain point and discuss a certain point that you have on your mind. The problem with Boethius, though, is that all his books are in the logic parts and the dialectics are all about topics and how you pick topics. So, the thing is, if you want to get further, you should read The Organon of Aristotle, even though we're talking about Platonicism, or De Invenzione of Cicero, because they both give you a pretty good finish up where Boethius does not finish. This is The Game Philosopher. Please like, comment, subscribe. Share this video. It was not a fascinating video, but I'll post more videos later.